Now, consider another example. This is a three-level memory system. There are cache memory, disk memory, and cache main memory. Now, cache access time given is 15 nanosecond, disk access time 80, heat ratio 0.96, main memory heat ratio 0.9. Now, the question is, what should be the main memory access time to achieve average memory access time or effective access time of 25 nanosecond? In my previous lecture, we have solved using two-level memory system. Now, the average access time of the memory system will be T average equal to HC into TC plus HM into 1 minus HC into TC plus TM plus 1 minus HC into 1 minus HM into TC plus TM plus TS. Here HC means heat ratio of the cache, TC means time to access from cache memory, HM means main memory heat ratio, 1 minus HC means miss ratio, HC means cache heat ratio, TC means time to access cache, TM means time to access from main memory, and TS means time to access from the secondary memory. Now we will put the value, we know the value of T is equal to 25, then 0.96 into 15 plus 0.9 into 0.04 into 15 plus TM plus 0.04 into 0.1 into 15 plus TM plus 80. Next, we'll simplify this equation and we'll get the value of TM will be 27. So, the main memory access time must be 27 nanosecond to achieve effective access time of 25 nanosecond. Good morning, students. Today, our topic is TLB. The full form of TLB is translation, look aside, buffer. Now we will see what is TLB. In paging scheme, the main memory is accessed two times to retrieve the data. What are the two times? One for accessing the page table, and another for accessing the data. The access time for main memory is large. So, one new technique is adopted to speed up the data retrieval. Here, a fast register is used to hold most recently used page table entries. When CPU need to access a particular page, TLB is accessed first if the desired page table entry is found in TLB page entry, then it is called TLB hit and the frame number is retrieved from the page table to get physical address in main memory. If the desired page table entry is not found in TLB, then it is called TLB miss. CPU searches for the page table in the main memory and after that it will retrieve the data. So here part of the pagemap table is kept in a high speed register that is called TLB. So now we will see grammatical representation of TLB. Here is your CPU that generates a logical address. One part is called page number, another part is called page offset. In case of paging, we have found that there is a page table. In the page table, page number where index that holds the corresponding frame number. But in TLB, this portion, suppose this portion is kept in a high speed register that is called your TLB. So here your frame number, here is your page number. So part of the page map table is kept in a high speed register. When CPU generate a logical address, it is divided into two parts, page number and page offset. This page number is used to access in the TLB. If the desired page is found in the TLB, then from here we'll get the frame number and we know that page offset equal to frame offset. If the desired page is not found in the TLB, then the main memory will be searched and from that we will get the frame number. And this frame number and frame offset will be your physical address. So that is all about TLB. Now we will see a numerical example on TLB. Suppose in a given problem, it is stated as TLB access time equal to 20 nanosecond, main memory access time equal to 100 nanosecond, TLB hit ratio equal to 0.8, we have to determine the average memory access time. The formula of average memory access time in case of cache memory, using cache memory it was h into tc plus 1 minus h into tc plus tm, where h was heat ratio, tc for time to access from cache memory, 1 minus h is miss ratio, then time to access from the cache memory, then time to access from the main memory. Using this similar concept, we have to compute the average memory access time in case of TLB. The formula will be TLB heat ratio into TLB access time plus main memory access time. So if the page is found in the TLB, then this. If the page is not found in the TLB, then it will be TLB miss ratio into TLB access time plus 2 into main memory access time. So if the desired page table entry is found in the TLB, then it will be TLB heat ratio into TLB access time, means time to access from that page table from the TLB, main memory access time, means we have found the page table entry into TLB. Now we will have to retrieve the data. In case of TLB miss, then it will be TLB miss ratio into TLB access time, because we have to first search for the desired page table entry in the TLB. If the desired page table entry is not found in the TLB, then we will have to search for the desired page table entry in the main memory. That's why there is one main memory access time. Again, after finding the desired page table entry, we have to find the data. That's why it is 2 into main memory access time. Next, we will have to just put an addition. So this is the formula of average memory access time in case of TLB. Now we will put the data. So TLB heat ratio from the given problem is 0.8. So we will write here 0.8 into TLB access time equal to 20 nanosecond plus main memory access time 100 plus TLB miss ratio 1 minus 0.8 into TLB access time 20 plus 2 into 100. So we will get 96 plus 44 equal to 140 nanosecond. So this is the average memory access time using TLB. Next, the topic is inverted page table. Why the inverted page table comes? In paging scheme, in case of page table, where page number act as an index. Page number 1, page number 2, page number 3, page number 4, that holds the corresponding frame number. But here, each process has a page table associated with it. One of the drawback of paging scheme is that each page table contain million of entries and thus may consume large amount of physical memory. To solve this concept, an inverted page table comes. An inverted page table has one entry for each frame which act as an index in the page table. Each entry consists of the virtual address of the page with its owner process ID. So, this is the concept of inverted page table. Here, the frame number will be act as an index that holds the corresponding page. Not only the page number, it will contain its owner process number. So, page number with its owner process number. So, this page table is known as inverted page table. Using this concept, the consume of large amount of physical memory will reduce. To illustrate between the paging technique and inverted page table, let us take an example. Suppose you have write down, you have three home in the whole district. In paging scheme, if you write down your home belongs to which district, then you will have to write here district 1, district 2, district 3, district 4, district 5, district 6 and so on. But there is valid entry only at two locations. So, this index will take a large amount of physical memory. To reduce the pace, we will do the following things. That means home 1, home 2, home 3, district, which district, which district, which district. So, this amount or this amount of space is not needed. By using this technique, we can reduce the consume of large amount of physical memory. That's why the inverted page table comes. Using this technique, it may decrease the amount of memory needed to store each page table, but it increases the amount of time needed to search the table. When a page reference occurs, because the inverted page table is sorted by physical address, but lookup occur on virtual address. The whole table might be searched for a match. This search need a much longer time. So we found that using this inverted page table, we can reduce the amount of memory needed, but it increases the search time. For this, we will use a hash table to limit the searches to one or most a few. So instead of inverted page table, we will search using a hash table, and that concept is known as hashed inverted page table. So we have moved from the page table to inverted page table, and from inverted page table we are moving now to hashed inverted page table. Generated by the CPU, the page number that is denoted as small p suffix j will be retrieved next. Step 2, the process identity number that is known as PID of the corresponding page number will be retrieved from process control block. Here, so first step is from logical address generated by the CPU, we will have to convert it into the binary, and we know that from the binary number how we can get the page number. The process was, the binary number was divided into two parts using the page size. The left part was page number and right part was page offset. So that was the procedure to compute the page number. Next, the process identity number of the corresponding page number will be retrieved from the PCB. The process identification number is denoted as PID. Step 3. This PID and P suffix J will be converted into binary equivalent. The two binary string will be merged to get a single string. The resultant string then will be converted into decimal equivalent, that is denoted as caps X. Next, step 4. Consider the number of entries in the page table equal to the nearest prime number of the number of frame available in the memory. Step 5. Apply hash function, that is denoted as hx equal to remainder of x comma a, where a equal to number of frame in page map table. Step 6. The result of the hash function will be denoted as V, which indicate the corresponding frame number of the pattern PID, EJ. So this is the 6th step by which the hash embedded page table is implemented. So first CPU generated the logical address, that is converted into binary. From that binary number, the step 1 was to compute the page number. Then we will find the process identification number, that PSD, PID from the process control block. Then PID and PJ will be converted into binary. Then these two binary strings will be converted to get a single string. The resultant string will be converted into decimal to get the value X. Next, step 4, we have to consider the number of entries in the page table equal to the nearest prime number of the number of frame available in the memory. That means if there are 100 page table entry in the 100 page table entry in the page table, then we will consider 97, because 99 is not prime, 98 is not prime, 97 is the prime. So the nearest prime number of the number of frame available in the memory, that is the concept of the nearest prime number. Then we have to apply HX. Apply HX means remainder of X comma A. Now the result of the hash function will be denoted as caps B, that is that indicates the corresponding frame number of the pattern PID and PJ. Now we will see a numerical example. Suppose the value of X equal to 24, that means PID plus PJ, this X is this one. Now the value of A equal to 11, that is frame number. So V will be 24 by 11, that means remainder will be 2, remainder of 24, 11, so we'll get 2 as a result. Now in another example, suppose A equal to 11, X equal to 35, so we'll get 35 by 11, that means 2. So, from this example, the conclusion is that there are two pages of two different processes that are stored in the same position. So, there will be a collision which can be resolved by applying linked least. How we will solve that? Suppose this is your linked list. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, in here, it will store 24, 11, that means PID plus PJ. Now, in the same location, there will be another process with the another page number. So, we will just linking the address, that will be QID plus PJ. So, this is the way by which we can avoid the collision. The example or the hashed inverted page table is used by IBM RS6000 computer and AS400 computer. So this is the whole concept of hashed inverted page table.